So my paper is about the consequences of the political, the nature of the political economy of the region on the outcome, labor market outcomes in particular. And I try to show that the use of the labor market as a political, as a tool of political appeasement, where you try to appease key critical groups like the middle class or like highly connected tribes or the nationals in the case of the GCC countries by giving them jobs in the public sector, results in distortions and segmentation of the labor market in such a way as to result in all the results that we see as characterizing what labor markets look like in the region, whether it's high youth unemployment, low and stagnant employment of women in the labor market, the investment, high levels of investment in education, but very low levels of educational performance and quality, very large public sectors and the importance of the public sector in the labor market. So those are the stylized facts, and I try to show how these stylized facts directly emerge from the fact that labor market are a political tool rather than an economic allocation tool. And I think that the most important is the long-term consequences this has on not just how human capital is deployed in the economy, but what sort of investments we have in human capital that then distort possibilities for the future, even if we can manage to remove the political use of labor markets in the moment.